The Neanderthal man, Homo neanderthalensis, is an extinct archaic representative of human evolution that lived during the Pleistocene in Europe and Western Asia. Its evolution proceeded in parallel with that of the modern human, Homo sapiens, but along a separate path. According to current evidence, the common ancestor of Homo sapiens and the Neanderthals lived in Africa, and the two lineages separated more than 500,000 years ago. After that, the ancestors of the Neanderthal lineage left Africa and continued to evolve in Eurasia, while the ancestors of Homo sapiens remained in Africa. The aim of this video is to explore the evolutionary origin of the Neanderthal man. Starting from the known direct ancestor for Homo heidelbergensis, we will move backwards in time towards the African ancestral species. Special attention is paid to the question of which subspecies or population of Homo erectus, according to current scientific consensus, left Africa, from which the Neanderthal man, but not the modern human, descends. In this way, we can identify the earliest known non-African ancestor of the Neanderthals, which is no longer common to the evolutionary line of Homo sapiens. Direct evolutionary predecessor of the Neanderthals is generally considered to be Homo heidelbergensis. This species or hominin lived approximately 600 to 300,000 years ago during the Middle Pleistocene and was found throughout Europe. Homo heidelbergensis is a robustly built, large-brained hominin that, in many respects, forms a transition between the earlier Homo erectus and the later Neanderthal man. Numerous European sites, for example, the Mauer 1 mandible found in Germany, approximately 600,000 years old, attest to its presence. Based on the latest finds, the European populations of Homo heidelbergensis can even be regarded as early Neanderthals, as they already exhibit characteristic Neanderthal features. An example of this is the population from the Cima de los Huesos cave, Atapuerca, in Spain, which is about 430,000 years old and can be considered the predecessor of the Neanderthals from an anatomical perspective. On the dentition and skeletal remains of these fossils, classic Neanderthal traits can also be observed, indicating that the Neanderthal lineage had been evolving in isolation for a long time. Genetic studies also confirm that the Cima de los Huesos people are early representatives of the Neanderthals. Analysis of ancient DNA has shown their relationship to the Neanderthal-Denisovan clade. Based on all this, Homo heidelbergensis, especially its European populations, was the direct ancestor of the Neanderthal man. It is important to note that Homo heidelbergensis was previously considered the last common ancestor of the Neanderthals and modern humans, but research in recent years has nuanced this view. To understand the evolutionary roots of the Neanderthal man, one must review the early representatives of European hominins. The earliest known hominin on the continent is Homo antecessor, which appeared in Western Europe around 1.2 to 0.8 million years ago, its main site being the Gran Dolina cave in Atapuerca, Spain. Its discoverers initially believed that this species could be the common ancestor of modern humans and Neanderthals, predating Homo heidelbergensis. The facial features of Homo antecessor are surprisingly modern-like: flat face, human-like brow ridge, although the known fossils mostly come from young individuals. However, later studies have nuanced its role. According to the latest paleoproteomic ancient protein analysis, Homo antecessor may have been a sister group to the Homo sapiens Neanderthal lineage, rather than their direct ancestor. In 2020, Frido Welker and colleagues, by sequencing 800,000-year-old tooth enamel proteins, demonstrated that Homo antecessor is in close phylogenetic relation to modern humans and Neanderthals, as well as the Denisovans. That is, it likely represents a sister group to a common ancestor. This means that Homo antecessor was likely an early offshoot shortly before the sapiens-Neanderthal split, but the species itself may not have been a direct ancestor of later human forms. Furthermore, newer studies have confirmed that the facial structure of Homo antecessor resembles Homo sapiens much more than Neanderthals or their predecessors. All this suggests that certain human characteristics developed much earlier, but were represented by a side branch of the population. Between the disappearance of antecessor around 800,000 years ago and the appearance of heidelbergensis in Europe around 600,000 years ago, few fossils are known. This gap is sometimes referred to in the literature as the Dark Age of Human Evolution. Nevertheless, there are indications that another hominin migration from Africa to Europe occurred at the beginning of the Middle Pleistocene. These migrants already introduced a more advanced stone tool culture, Acheulean, and likely formed populations known as Homo heidelbergensis. The European Homo heidelbergensis may have partly descended from the earlier Homo antecessor, or may have arrived entirely newly from Africa, replacing the previous population. In any case, about half a million years ago, hominin groups already lived in Europe that began to show the characteristics of later Neanderthals. This is indicated, for example, by the Soprano find in Italy around 450,000 years and the aforementioned Cima de los Huesos fossils. The Middle Pleistocene humans, the Heidelbergensis group, adapted to colder climates in Europe, for example, practicing a hunting lifestyle and likely already using fire. The 300,000-year-old footprints at the Schöningen site, Germany, are also associated with this group and confirm their presence and behavior in Northern Europe. Investigating the African roots of Homo neanderthalensis requires us to look back to earlier species of the genus Homo, particularly Homo erectus and its variants. Homo erectus appeared 2 million years ago and was the first human species to spread over large areas outside Africa. As early as about 1.8 million years ago, it reached the Caucasus region, Dmanisi, Georgia, and later spread throughout Asia, for example, Java man and Peking man. African Homo erectus populations are often given a separate name, Homo ergaster, as they differed somewhat from their Asian counterparts. It was Homo ergaster that developed in Africa and, according to many researchers, is the direct ancestor of both later European and African hominins. In fact, Homo ergaster erectus became a chronospecies. It persisted over a long period and evolved gradually. One branch of this species later, around 700 to 600,000 years ago, evolved into new species in Africa, such as Homo heidelbergensis. Most paleontologists believe that the direct ancestors of the Neanderthals were a population belonging to a late Homo erectus variant that left Africa during the Middle Pleistocene. In the traditional model, a group of African Homo heidelbergensis migrated to Europe shortly before 500,000 years ago and, after becoming isolated there, continued to evolve into Neanderthal man. This migration was therefore separate from the population that remained in Africa and ultimately evolved into Homo sapiens. In other words, the Neanderthal lineage represents a separate out-of-Africa wave in the history of the genus Homo. This is supported by the fact that the genetic makeup of the Neanderthals, for example, their mitochondrial DNA, does not descend from African modern human populations, but from an earlier migrating group. The African ancestral form in question can be regarded as a subspecies or descendant of Homo erectus. Some researchers use the names Homo rhodesiensis, or more recently Homo bodoensis, for Middle Pleistocene African hominins to distinguish them from the European pre-Neanderthals. The point, however, is that by that time, the developmental paths of Neanderthals and modern humans had already diverged. The former's ancestors had left Africa, while the latter's remained at home. It is important to emphasize that not every Homo population outside Africa became an ancestor of the Neanderthals. The early Homo erectus, such as the aforementioned Javan and Chinese finds, lived in Asia for several hundred thousand years, but according to current knowledge, they represented an evolutionary dead end with respect to Homo neanderthalensis. The development of the Neanderthal lineage is much more closely linked to the second major migration wave that occurred during the Middle Pleistocene. This wave brought the Homo heidelbergensis type humans to Europe, who then split into several isolated populations into classic Neanderthals in Western Europe and Denisovans in East Asia, which show genetic affinity. Thus, a late African descendant population of Homo erectus can be considered the direct African ancestor of the Neanderthal man, which is no longer an ancestor of our species. The evolutionary relationship between modern humans and Neanderthals was long disputed, but paleoanthropology and paleogenetics together have drawn the family tree. Both genetic and fossil evidence suggest that the lineages of Homo sapiens and Homo neanderthalensis diverged at least 500 to 600,000 years ago. Some molecular clock calibrations place the split at around 650,000 years ago, while certain morphological analyses, for example a 2019 study examining tooth shape, place it even earlier, possibly more than 800,000 years ago. This latter assumption is reinforced by the fact that the teeth of the Cima de los Huesos people who lived 430,000 years ago already differ significantly from what we would expect of a common ancestor, suggesting a long independent evolution. On the phylogenetic tree, the closest relatives of Neanderthals are the Denisovans, who lived in Asia. Paleogenetic studies have shown that the Neanderthal and Denisovan lines diverged from a common population that had left Africa, their ancestors separated together from the Homo sapiens lineage. From this, we can infer that part of Homo heidelbergensis and related forms split into two branches in Asia and Europe. The western branch became the Neanderthal man, and the eastern branch formed the Denisovan group. These two groups later remained in genetic contact to some extent. For example, Denisovan gene segments are known in the genomes of late Neanderthals, suggesting that their distribution areas overlapped in the Central Asian region. All this happened independently of the emergence of Homo sapiens. The ancestors of our species remained in Africa, and only much later, around 300,000 years ago, did Homo sapiens become a distinct species, and then approximately 60 to 70,000 years ago began its global migration. By then, the Neanderthals had long been established in Europe and Asia with their own distinct evolutionary history. As a result, the Neanderthal genome accumulated many mutations that are not present in modern humans, and vice versa. Thus, the Neanderthal and modern humans are two closely related species, but they follow different evolutionary paths from the common ancestor. Phylogenetically, the last common ancestor of Homo neanderthalensis and Homo sapiens was presumably a Homo population that lived in Africa during the Middle Pleistocene. For a long time, Homo heidelbergensis was identified as this common ancestor, but according to newer data, Homo heidelbergensis itself belongs to the Neanderthal lineage, and the split occurred earlier. Based on genetic evidence, for example, the 2016 nuclear DNA data from Cima de los Huesos, it has been proposed that the entire Homo heidelbergensis species was part of the European Neanderthal lineage as early Neanderthals, while the time of divergence can be placed somewhere between 600 to 800,000 years ago, roughly coinciding with the period of Homo antecessor. According to this scenario then, both Homo antecessor and Homo heidelbergensis appeared after or during the sapiens-Neanderthal split, and thus the earliest exclusive ancestors of the Neanderthal man are to be sought in these two forms. Although the details, for example, the exact classification of individual populations, remain subjects of debate, the main branching pattern is clear. The Neanderthal-Denisovan clade separated from the Homo sapiens branch before the latter species had formed. In summary, the evolutionary origin of the Neanderthal man is a story of a lineage that began in Africa and then continued in Eurasia. Its direct predecessor is considered to be the European Homo heidelbergensis, whose populations during the Middle Pleistocene, around 500,000 years ago, already carried the characteristics of later Neanderthals. Tracing back to the African roots, we found that according to current scientific consensus, the earliest non-African ancestor of the Neanderthals was a descendant population of Homo erectus, presumably Homo heidelbergensis-like. That left Africa approximately 600 to 700,000 years ago. This population continued to evolve in isolation in Europe and Western Asia, and eventually developed into Homo neanderthalensis. Meanwhile, the ancestors of Homo sapiens remained in Africa, so their evolutionary path diverged. It is important to emphasize that this migrating ancestor is no longer shared with Homo sapiens, but can be considered exclusively an ancestor of the Neanderthal and Denisovan line. This was the early ancestral population that, by taking a new evolutionary path in Eurasia, created the Neanderthal man, a close but separate branch of the human family tree. In recent years, paleogenetic ancient DNA and protein research has increasingly refined these details, but the main dividing line, that the earliest independent ancestor of the Neanderthal man was a Homo erectus heidelbergensis population that left Africa, rests on solid scientific foundations.